So once you've established a relationship with an ally and you begin to use and work with them, you have to take care of them. You need to feed that relationship. It's like a friendship. If you never keep in touch with your friend and you don't spend time with them or call them up sometimes, that relationship will suffer. It won't be as fruitful or as deep as it could be. And you might even lose it eventually. And it's the same thing with allies. They like to be greeted and thanked on a regular basis. So I include thanking my allies, my personal allies, as part of my daily practice. Even if I'm not calling on them directly for some reason, they like to get offerings. You know, they like me to acknowledge them. Here's some cornmeal or tobacco for you, you know. So when you take care of your allies, then they take care of you and they will show up for you even when you haven't called on them directly. They will protect you. They will be there when you need them most. So this is part of a bigger and really important concept in shamanism called reciprocity. And reciprocity is the idea that there's always an exchange of energy. There always has to be an exchange of energy. There is a give and take. So you want your allies to help you, then you have to give back to them. And it's done in the spirit of gratitude and gifting. But there always has to be reciprocity. And it's the spirit of it that counts, the intention. So it doesn't matter what it is in some ways that you give back, as long as you do. An offering could be a song or some fruit you might have or whatever as an offering. As long as the offering is gifted with an open heart and generosity, then an ally is happy with it. And most shamanic traditions would agree that an offering is best done before you ask for something. So that's even included in this little process of directing the ally. You know, when you talk to your ally, you start with gratitude and compliments. That's a gift to the ally. That's important.